Okay, welcome back to Learn More JavaScript on the ServiceNow platform. Behind the scenes, I had to record that line like 8 times. I just kept messing it up. Anyways, if you are tuning in from the last lesson, we just got out of Glide Ajax, and now we're going to be talking about GlideForm. It's commonly referred to as G underscore form, so GForm. This powerful API, it allows us to interact with and manipulate forms within ServiceNow. So if you were here for the Glide Ajax talk, we're manipulating things on the form without actually accessing the server. So this is all stuff that will be happening within the user's browser, and it's not affecting anything in the actual server. It's not saving anything, but it's useful because we might want to change something on the form before we actually talk to the server. So use this API because it provides methods to customize your form behavior. It does things like set field values for the user. It can make things read-only. It can hide fields. It can do a lot of things. And we're going to try to show you how important it is to use this Glide form method because it's real-time. And it's very useful for the user experience that you might want for your users. Okay. So for example, one of the things that we might want to do is update this short description to, say, add the priority to it so that it's always in the short description, so it's easy to read from the short description. That's just an example. To do Glide form stuff, we're going to do it via the client script. So I'm going to jump into the client scripts table, and I'm going to say new client script. And I want this one to update the short description with priority. And we're going to run this on the incident table. And I want this to be when the priority field changes. And the script down here, we're going to go ahead and say g underscore form dot set value. And we're going to change the short description. We're going to say the new priority is, and we're going to say new value. So on these client scripts, we're already given some fields that we can use. So we can have the old value of what that field was, and we can have the new value of what that field is. So that's what we're using here. I'm going to go ahead and save this client script, go back to incident, and let's pick a random incident to open. And we'll see here, if I go down here to show short description, if we change the priority, you notice that the priority changed, and then our client script activated, and GForm takes control and changes the short description, because that's what we told it to do, to the new priority is 3. And we can actually keep demonstrating that. Now it says new priority is 5. And if we put it back to high, it'll say new priority is 1. Notice that at no time there was a loading icon, or we didn't hit save or update on the record itself. So nothing's actually happening yet on the server side. This is all still within my browser. This is as if the user has changed it themselves, basically. Until they hit update, nothing has happened in the server. Now, if I go back to my new client script that I just created, I can show you a couple of other things that we could be doing. So maybe I don't want to replace the entire thing with the new priority is new value. What if I want to just add it to the end of it? So we can say over here, we're going to say gform get value of the original short description. So get value is the way to get information from your form. And we're going to add that to the beginning of our script. Let's go ahead and update that. Go back to incident. Open our random incident. And you'll see here, how do I create a subfolder is a current short description. Now, if I change the priority, it didn't just wipe out the entire short description. It took the short description and then took the new information and then put them together. So that's how you get value. And then lastly, if I go back to my client script and I keep it on when the priority field changes, we can do a little bit of other things on the form. So just for example, I'm going to say when the priority changes, we're going to set read only to, and I'm picking a random field, assignment group, and we're going to say true, because is it read only? Yes. And the reverse is true. If it's an already read only field, you can say false and it becomes editable at that point. But for this one, I know assignment group is not read only already, so I'm going to set it to true. And then I'm also going to do set display. I'm going to make the impact field completely disappear. So when the priority field changes, that means assignment group should become read only and the entire impact field should be removed from the user's display. It still exists on the table. It just doesn't show up for the user anymore. So I'm going to go ahead and update that. Go back to my incident. I'll open a different one this time. And we'll see here's the impact field, and where's the assignment group field? Here it is. Here's the assignment group field. So if I go ahead and change the priority, you'll notice that impact completely disappeared as I wanted it to. And then assignment group now is read only. So there you go. That's how you can manipulate the form using scripting, using GForm or GlideForm.